guys, welcome back to another MCreator Lore video. So today what we're going to be working on is getting the blocks set up and the procedures. We won't be working on the mechanics today, mainly because there's going to be quite a bit of different mechanics we need to build into the actual crops themselves, but we will be working on a couple different things. I wanted to get started with the model for the seeds that are going to be on the kind of like a plane that we'll be setting. So I want to have different, a little bit different system than the vanilla crops. However, given that our weeds are on a cross kind of model, we will still need to use the same model type. It's like for the actual model itself, but I also want to make sure that we have other abilities, like using the seeds, so we can actually display that the seeds have been planted and stuff. Something a little bit different than just planting the plant itself. In many cases, this wouldn't be the case. For things like plants and stuff, you would have a seed layer, or, you know, seeds that you would put on your field or in your field, depending on how you sow the land. Some plants are able to be planted on top. It depends on the plant itself. Some of them need certain depths and stuff like that. But in our case, we're going to just make it so it's a little bit easier to see, and we're going to basically set up the view position for the seed layer. And I did end up going back and adjusting some of the properties for these. I did this on camera later on towards the end of the video, but I just wanted to make sure that the players could actually see the block itself, and that, you know, the location and everything is actually relative to something that, if it was to be used for something, for like a hat or something like that, it would actually look properly set up. So the next thing that I needed to do was set up the item texture. Now this I was going to just set like a regular item texture, but it said it wasn't going to support that for some reason. Not sure why. So I just had to kind of play around with it myself. I had to like rotate it, try to get it centered roughly, and set the rotation. So I think we should be fine if we were to set the size to 1 for the item size, and the location to 0, and then set the rotation to 90. I'm not sure if that's proper rotation or not, but it's just a wild guess to see if we get it right. If not, that's okay. We can always fix it later. I ended up adding the seeds, and then I went ahead and I needed to create the crops for like a crop folder, so we know where all the crops are. We'll be making rice, obviously, and one of the other crops that I wanted to add was a double crop, which is like a double block crop, which is corn, which will be a little bit more interesting to work on because it's a double plant kind of thing, but we can probably make something work based on the circumstances. Like, I've done double crops before using in the basic series, so it shouldn't be too hard to do. And I wanted the model to be cut out, and then I was just generating the thing, and then I remembered that the hitbox needs to be a little bit different for some of these properties, and I went back and actually set up the properties between 0.001 and I believe it was 1 or something like that, just so it was properly like measured, so there was sort of like a hitbox. If it's the same size, I don't think it renders, or it can't render at certain points. So I don't want it to drop anything. We're going to have a specific block for this when the crop goes to seed. So we're not going to actually give back seeds when the player breaks it. We're going to want it under the plant sound though. And I'm going to set the tick rate to 1. Later on, I actually put it onto a random tick because that would probably work better for the growth. So I'm going to use that as like the base, because then people can use the the game settings for the tick rate for the game. This is usually set by set on 3, but they can speed this up to like 1,000 or whatever, and it'll almost instantly grow. I wanted to check the colors for the map, though. I ended up adding this page to the wiki page on mcreator.net. It has all the different colors icons, so people can see what the colors are for all the icons and stuff like that. Overall, there is quite a bit of different colors in this particular thing. I think I'm going to use a few of these for determining the stage of the crop, depending on what kind of material the crop yields and the type of basically what stage it's at. So basically for the crops itself, now I needed to look up basically if the plant was flammable. And I know crops aren't, but I want the crops to have more realistic behavior. So say if there's a lightning strike or something like that, I want to make sure that there are circumstances. Things can go terribly wrong. So I'm adding 60 flammability to the blocks themselves. This is going to be the same as grass, so it'll burn quite quickly. And it does make sense when you think about it. We might adjust the crop layer, like the crop flammability, based on the growth stage in the next video. But one of the things that I will have to work on is making sure that the block below is basically the tilled soil. So we need tilled soil, and I needed to go ahead and set the hitbox for this block up, or not the hitbox, the position for the test. So I'm going to test below if the block is tilled soil. Now if this is the case, then what I want to do is I want to return the value for this particular thing. So example is if it's going to be on the block that I want it to be on. If not, it should break. So I want it to break if that's the case. And we're going to just double check some of these settings. We're going to need a block added and a update tick for the growth. So these are two things that we're going to need to set up based on the block itself. So I'm just going over the other properties. I don't think there's anything really else that we need to set up that would be relevant to the system. We might make a right click event later on, but at the moment I don't think we need it. And then it's just a matter of setting up the other stages. So we need stage one, and this will be this block right here. And I think at this point, this is where I noticed I needed a actual model for this. I wanted to specify a custom model just so the rendering and stuff is proper. So I went ahead and went into the Minecraft files and searched for the crop stage. I realized you can't actually just import a model from like through a plugin or anything through Blockbench, so I had to go and find the file in the folder for all the models and stuff like that. I had a feeling that it would probably be a generic model that the crops like carrots and stuff inherit. So I was correct on that part. I went over the code and it looked pretty basic. So I was going to bring it into Blockbench, and I decided I could probably just import it directly, but that was kind of a mistake because the position of the blocks and stuff like that, like the display settings, it wasn't set up. I didn't actually see that in the config file. So I ended up having to go ahead and set that. Now, what I'm doing right now is setting up instances for each of the models themselves. I ended up having to redo this, but basically what it allows you to do is rather than import every model, you can use the same model but have different instances. So basically the model, these are going to create models, but it's going to call a base block, like a base model with all the settings and stuff. So it's just going to go, okay, I need this one, inherit all the settings from that particular one with these textures. So that's basically what it does when you're using that little feature there. Now for this, I needed to set up the hitboxes. Later on, I actually realized I wasted my time doing this, and I had to go back and set up the hitboxes correctly. So fun note, it should be a pane kind of like on the ground and not a actual hitbox relevant to the crop. So the whole step that I ended up doing was kind of not needed, but I ended up doing it anyways. I could have just gotten away with using the built-in one, I think. But making sure that I have an actual model set up ready for use and stuff like that. So once I got the properties all set up, I went ahead and created the other textures and set up the other models for the thing. There wasn't too many other things that I needed to get done. I just can create all the different blocks, and then if there's anything else that I needed to do. I think there was a few different things that I changed. I realized I wasn't updating the color, and some of the other things that I didn't do was make it tick randomly for all these other ones. So I did end up doing that rather than using a static tick rate. And there was, what was the other thing that I did? I actually worked on the colors for basically the stage. So I think I used iron, raw iron, for the harvesting version, for ready for harvest for the actual crop itself. There was the white terracotta for the actual the seeding texture, and then I think I used brown for the dead one, and then there was another texture for dark green terracotta, which I used for the last stage for the green stage before it went into ready for harvest. And then there was the lime terracotta, which I used for the middle stages. And then I just used lime for the base stage. And the seeds don't actually render any particular map color. It will actually display error, which will make sure that it doesn't generate any color. It will inherit the color from the block below it. So that's basically the color maps that I ended up working on. Again, I wouldn't mind to adjust the flammability in the future. Probably next episode I'll be working on that. I figure the seeds will probably be higher flammability. That would probably make more sense because they would probably end up being dry. Or we could set them to no flammability, I guess, because there would be technically underground, right? So that would kind of make sense. And then from stage one and stage two would probably be the like a lower flammability level. And then the stage three and stage four will be like a moderate. And then the harvest, ready for harvest, and then the dead one will be at higher levels. So they'll be a little bit higher than each time it goes up from a stage. I think that would work perfectly fine. Let me know in the comments if you think that's a good idea. I'll kind of get some feedback based on that, and I'll see what I can come up with for alternative ideas if that doesn't work. But yeah, basically that's what I'm doing. I'm just working on setting up the color on the map, making sure that they are set up in a way that it would work, like I described, all the different colors. And I will probably end up adding bone meal conditions to these as well. We have the support for that for each crop itself, I didn't actually set that up because they need to be manually done for each stage, unfortunately. But we should be able to get that set up without needing to create a custom bone meal script like I have done in the past for the basic crop series. But this is basically where I ended up setting up the panes for the crops themselves. So I had to redo all these and set up the hitboxes for the thing. Now, the reason for that was, again, in the game, when you're harvesting a block, if you're to try harvesting the same model as the crops themselves, you might end up breaking the block underneath it, which would be a really nuisance to actually have to do. So, because you would lose the values and the MBT from that particular block, right? So what I wanted to do is make sure that when the player harvests the material, like the plant itself, that they'll be able to just click, like, break anywhere. So I'm using the same method that Vanilla Minecraft uses for just basically setting it up. Another thing that I needed to do was set up the actual display for all the blocks and make sure that they're all set up in a reasonable manner. I usually like putting things on top of the player's heads just because it looks funnier and it looks just unnatural, but you know, it could be seen as a certain thing. Sometimes you want to put it somewhere else, but in the case of like 3D models, it's just easier to put on top of their head. All right, so the display settings, these should all be good now. I'm going to save this model, and then we can go ahead and say or export the crops. I'm just going to exit out just to make sure that it saves all the data. Sometimes when you override JSON files, they have issues with the system. So I think it has to do with the read and writing thing in Blockbench. I think it might be constantly reading the file. I'm not sure if that's the case, but sometimes it just has issues with writing to the JSON file if it's not deleted first. All right, so basically in game, these are the stages that how they turned out. I'm pretty happy with the actual look of these. They're really well done for textures and stuff. You can't really see the seeds too well, but you can see the stages. They look really good. They get greener as time goes on, and then you can kind of see the different growth, and then you have all the stages as you would expect. So that would be the seeding one, that would be the ready for harvest. You have the one back there, which is for dead plants, and then you have all the different stages for that, and then you have the seeding stage. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. We will go ahead and work on the mechanics next episode. I just want to see though what it will actually look like with the weeds and the rocks and stuff, because this is going to be a huge mechanic once we start working in the fertileness and stuff like that, that we worked on the crops or the tilled soil themselves. So let's go ahead and just take a quick look. So basically, as you can kind of see, the cross model was a good idea because we can use the crop one for the crops themselves. So this looks really well done with the rocks and stuff. It's a little hard to see the seeds, but the seeds are there, and it just blends in really well with the crops. So I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. We'll probably work on the mechanics next episode for the crops, start working on the growth mechanics, and then we'll expand into getting the script set up for testing for the block below for the fertileness, the rockiness, all those other conditions that we ended up making for the soil. But the first step is to make sure that the crop will actually grow over time, and then we'll start adding the advanced mechanics and stuff later on. So outside of that, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, comment down below, rate the video, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Peace out.